Singleness in the Glory of Praiseburg, page 686. A reading from the book of Kings. Elijah went a day's journey into the desert until he came to a broom tree and sat beneath it. He prayed for death, saying, "This is enough, O Lord. Take my life, for I am no better than my fathers." He lay down and fell asleep under the broom tree. But then an angel touched him and ordered him to get up and eat. Elijah looked, and there at his head was a hard cake and a jug of water. After he ate and drank, he lay down again. But the angel of the Lord came back a second time, touched him, and ordered, "Get up and eat. The journey will be too long for you." He got up, ate, and drank. Then, strengthened by that food, he walked 40 days and 40 nights to the mountain of God, Horeb. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall be in my mouth. Let my soul glory in the Lord. The lowly will hear me and be glad.
Taste and see the goodness of the Lord.
Glorify the Lord with me. Let us together extol his name. I sought the Lord, and he answered me and delivered me from all my fears. Look to him that you may be radiant with joy, and your faces may not blush with shame. When the afflicted man called out, the Lord heard, and from all his distress he saved him. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him and delivers them. Taste and see how good the Lord is. Bless the man who takes refuge in him. A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Ephesians. Brothers and sisters, do not grieve the Holy Spirit of God, with which you were sealed for the day of redemption. All bitterness, fury, anger, shouting, and reviling must be removed from you, along with all malice. And be kind to one another, compassionate, forgiving one another as God has forgiven you in Christ. So be imitators of God as beloved children and live in love as Christ loved us and handed himself over for us as a sacrificial offering to God for a fragrant aroma. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. The Jews murmured about Jesus because he said, "I am the bread that came down from heaven." And they said, "Is this not Jesus, the son of Joseph? Do we not know his father and mother? Then how can he say, 'I have come down from heaven'?" Jesus answered and said to them, "Stop murmuring among yourselves. No one can come to me unless the Father who sent me draw him, and I will raise him on the last day. It is written in the prophets, 'They shall all be taught by God.' Everyone who listens to my Father and learns from him comes to me. Not that anyone has seen the Father, except the one who is from God. He has seen the Father. Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever believes has eternal life. I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate manna in the desert, but they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that one may eat it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever. And the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We have the scandalous reaction of the Jewish leaders to Jesus' declaration, "I am the bread that came down from heaven." The protest is against God the Son, whose origins they know are from Joseph and Mary. However, to know and believe in Jesus is only for those who listen and learn to God the Father, who sent the Son to be the Messiah. Jesus reminds the Jews that their ancestors ate manna in the desert, bread that God gave them in response to their complaints to Moses and Aaron. However, they died because the manna was perishable. It could not be kept overnight, and it would only show up every morning. In this scene with Jesus, the Jews complain in response to God's offer of living bread, the offer of Jesus to be living bread. Jesus is the living bread, and whoever eats his flesh will live forever. We know now that Jesus was talking about the real presence in the Eucharist. And yet today, Jesus encounters the same reaction he did back in his days with the Jewish leaders. A 2019 Pew Research Center study showed that only 31% of Catholics believe in the real presence in the Eucharist, whereas 69% believe the Eucharist is a symbol of the body and blood of Christ. Even among practicing Catholics, those of us who are here, only 63% of us believe in the real presence. Among the reasons cited for doubting in the real presence are poor catechesis, communion in the hand, lay Eucharistic ministers, Vatican II, prophet that says, those who learn from God, listen and learn from God, will be taught by God. Transubstantiation simply means that the substance of the Eucharist, the little wafer, the host, is the deepest reality changed from the bread, and the wine itself changed from the wine to the body and the blood. The external properties, the wafer still looks like wafer, the wine still looks like wine, but it is no longer wafer and wine. It is now body and blood. Or better said, the body still looks like a host, communion host, and the blood still looks like wine, but it is now the blood of Christ. The issue with the Eucharist today is that skeptics murmur for the fact that they know where it came from. We know where the wafer, the bread comes from. We know where the wine comes from. It is man-made. That's why it is so hard for some of us to accept the doctrine of transubstantiation. One priest said it recently in a homily, it is easier for us to believe in the Tylenol that the doctor prescribed you than in the Eucharist. There was a time when I did not understand the real presence of God in the Eucharist. But I had faith in God. And when I was experiencing an ordeal, I would come into church, into the sanctuary, and I would pray to Him on the cross. My devotion was correct, but my faith was in the wrong place. The cross is the symbol. The Eucharist is Christ. God is present in the Eucharist, in the tabernacle. So in essence, I did not know it because I was praying over the tabernacle to the cross, but in essence, I was praying to God Himself. He was present. He knew my heart. He knew what my intentions were. Today, as then, Jesus is seeking faith. He challenges to move beyond only what we can see and to entrust our lives to God. May God bless you and Mary keep you under her care.
Yeah. Let us pray with concern for the needs of others.
That the Eucharistic Church may express its communion with Christ by a constant ministry of charity and mercy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the Father may draw all the nations to the eternal reign of his Son. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Those who see in me for God in their lives may be drawn back to the nourishment of the Eucharist. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And we may recognize Jesus at the altar, giving himself up in our place as a fragrant offering and a sacrifice to God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
And the faithful departed who received the bread of life may live forever. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Those intentions which we hold silently in our heart. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Father, we believe in you and in your Son, our Eucharist. Grant petitions of this community if they be according to your will. And we ask this through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Sing our offertory song to God, 646, 646 in your glory and praise book. Christians, let us love one another.
Glory as without end we acclaim. your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather our people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts that we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles, glorious martyrs, with Saint Stephen and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all of the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good.
Through him and with him and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.
May the communion and your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a few brief announcements. The first is that myself and Father Kevin will be on priest retreat, so nobody gets to go to the hospital or die. We will have Father Joseph from La Mesa. He'll be helping us out during the week with our daily masses, and we thank him for that. He's an retired priest of the Diocese of Lubbock, and so we thank him for his assistance in this. The other thing is of course, make sure that if you haven't already, to make an effort to sign your kids up for confirmation classes, CCD, etc., as that will be beginning here in about a month or so. So if you can, please be sure to sign up for that. The Lord be with you.
And
may God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forward. The Mass is in.
Thanks be to God.
Sing with us on 690, 690, sing of the Lord's goodness. 690.